Vice Chancellor, and Chairman of this occasion, Professor Suleiman Ajay Abdulkarim, the Deputy Vice Chancellor Academic, Professor Sylvia Malomo, Deputy Vice Chancellor of Management Services, Professor P.F. Sule, the University Registrar, Dr. Fola Oluwoleni, University Librarian, Professor Kwaha Mariwaju Isa, the Provost College of Health Sciences, Professor Mariwaju Adedoyin, ably represented by the Dean Basic Medical Sciences, Professor Akiola, the inaugural lecturer of today, Professor Olufumilola Dominic, the Dean Postgraduate School, Professor Mojisola Bakari Okunla, Deans of various faculties here present, the Director of Academic Planning, Professor Isaac Ademola, Director of various units and centers here present, distinguished professors here present, our traditional rulers here present, the university scholars here present, the staff and students of the university here present, our distinguished guests here present and virtually present, distinguished members of the press, ladies and gentlemen, you're welcome to the 208th in the series of inaugural lectures of this university. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, the 208th in the series of inaugural lectures of the University of Ilorin has been entitled Movement Maintenance, Performance Interlude of Trauma, Mortality, and Wellness. And it is to be delivered by Professor Olufumilola Dominic. It's over to you, Mr. Vice Chancellor.
Let me start by saying a very warm good afternoon to all of us in the audience here and those joining us virtually. I'll now invite our inaugural lecturer of today to please stand. Standing before you is Professor Leah Olufumilola Dominic, and she was born on 23rd February 1962 in Kumasi, Ghana, to Father Samuel Ogunsanya Fagbinu and Mother Felicia Omoyola Fagbinu. She's an indigene of the Wikesha in Uriati local government area of Osho State. Professor Ms. Dominic attended Women Teachers College, Mina, Niger State from 1974 to 1979. She also was a student at Oyo State College of Education, Ilesha, now Osho State College of Education, from 1980 to 1983. She got a BSc and Master's degree in Science Education, respectively, in 1996 and 1999 from the University of Ilorin. She obtained a PhD in Exercise and Sports Science in 2011 from Modibello University, Zaria, Abuja. Let's have a close speech. Thank you. Professor Ms. Leah Olufumilola Dominic started a lecturing career on 3rd June 2002 as an assistant lecturer and rose through the rank to become a professor on 1st of October 2018. Thank you. She's a member of some professional bodies, among which are the following. She's a member of the International Council of Health, Physical Education, Recreation, Sports, and Dance, and she has been since 2015 to date. She's also a member of American Society, for the Association of Sports. some of them are listed here, there are two of them listed here. Chairman of Auto Foundation Committee for March 2021. He's also the postgraduate program coordinator, Institute of Education, University of Ilorin for 2015 to 2017. Miss Lina Ulfumilola Dominic has lots of international and locally various publications to her credit. She's happily married with children and grandchildren. And before you, you don't want to have to do.
Of my life, the fulfillment of God's promises to take me from mere clay
sparkling lab coats treated me with all care, and that they gave me a vision to run with. Bami, my kawe, my dokitan, my kodunias, mam, simply meaning my father. I was studying to become a medical doctor and take care of you and my mom. This became a lifetime dream. All foreigners, especially Nigerians, must go to Abuja in 1968. Brought us back to Nigeria thinking the dream was gone. My encounter with my aunt at Christmas of 1969 reactivated the dream when I spoke in English and tied me to follow her to the north, specifically Niger State, where I continued my primary education. The fear of sending a village girl to school made me lose admission to Queen's College, Lagos. But fortunately, I got admission to Women Teachers College, MENA, in Niger State to pursue 5-year teacher education program conducted by YA between 1974 and 1979. The dream to become a medical doctor spurred me on to attend the best student from 1 to from 5, taking the second position only once. The journey to study physical education started with the transfer of our general science and health science teachers at the third term of Form 4 with no replacement. We were all forced not to register for the subject in order not to fail it, thus killing my dream of becoming a medical doctor. After the WAMS examination, in which I had 4 A's and 4 B's, among which PE was one, I found out about all the areas, and as a teacher grade 2 graduate, the closest course to promoting health and performance to me was physical education. Hence, this laid the foundation of my career to this day. I proceeded to the State College of Education in Lesha between 1980 and 1983, and after my NYC, I returned to the university. The interest to go back to school for promotion was hindered again and again to receive an interview letter a week late until 1992, when I became a senior basketball coach in Niger State Sports Council. God remains faithful. I realized dreams and vision never die unless the career of the vision and dream has. My beloved God's plan kept motivating me to take a step towards pursuing my dream. This brought me back to school after the academic strike of 1992 and 3. As a direct entry student with 8 months of fees, I give God the glory for clinching the best graduating students of the physical education department. My lecturers encouragement, my husband's support helped me attain my master's degree in exercise physiology in 1999. My academic journey. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, my academic journey started on 3rd June 2002 as an assistant lecturer, and I became a professor of exercise and sports science in 2018. My academic research started with a bias for my basketball. Later, I became interested in health and performance, especially in relation to body proportionality and wellness through physical movement. This led to my PhD in exercise and sports science with a thesis in movement mechanics titled Kinematic Analysis of Arm Motion During Jump Shots in Nigerian Female Basketballers to determine the shooting techniques and physical characteristics of any female players compared to professional international players. To address the lecture of today, definitions and some clarifications need to be made so that my audience can have in-depth understanding of the discourse. These clarifications may positively change the perception among stakeholders to embrace a holistic approach to movement behavior integration into daily living and community health education. And community health education, I will start with the keywords in the title, movement mechanics. Movement mechanics simply means the techniques of coordinating the human body to produce good motion. Optimal coordination is required for high output and mechanical effectiveness. Poor movement technique leads to poor body coordination, ineffectiveness, and loss of power. Your body is a machine that should not be parked. The human body is like a machine. It's a complex system of many interconnected and interacting parts. It is a multifaceted natural machine designed for movement, dynamic survival functions, realization of full potential and fulfilled life when it is not parked like an automobile through sedentariness or disease. Any form of breakdown in the body requires immediate repair to prevent further damage to its durability and sustainability. The human body is a wonderful machine that performs multidimensional functions without resting from birth and stops only in death or death of a body part, such as stroke and paralysis.
tranquility. Therefore, according to Aristotle, movement is life, life is movement. The less the movement, the more the exposure of the body to injury, mobility, and mortality risk. Movement is a path for growth and development, for early living and a sustainable, healthy lifestyle. Concept of movement. Movement is a term used by almost all, but not in relation to exercise and physical activity, and not designed from physiological dimension. Mechanically, movement was defined as work, while geometrically, it is defined as a change of place of position, from a reference point. Bowman expressed his belief and proposed that, in addition to this general idea of a body changing its position in space, movement should be additionally defined as any motion that creates a change in the shape of a body or parts of a body, and need not be bound to an intentional and caloric expenditure and limited to physical fitness variables. Movement is an integral part of every function and process within the body, with bodies and all the environment. Natural body movement includes walking, running, bending, landing, jumping, crawling, carrying, and reaching, among others. The human body can move and be moved in numerous ways, beyond those that utilize skeletal muscle or contribute to physical fitness performance. Yet, it could relate to various health outcomes. For instance, yawning that causes goose pimples moves the body entirely, but is neither related to physical fitness nor therapy. The concept of movement, therefore, in this lecture, connotes all types of human motion, functional tasks, physical activity, and exercise. This makes movement not just a mechanical connotation, but encompassing physiological, biological, psychological, sociological, and biomechanical dimensions. A new definition of movement, therefore, recognizes physical activity and exercise as related subcategories of movement. The dichotomy of movement, physical activity, exercise, and prescription. Physical activity refers to all movements involving large muscles of the body that increase energy expenditure by utilizing calories. For example, activity of daily living such as shopping, gardening, housing, childbearing, among others, riding a bicycle for transportation, sports or exercise, and work-related activities. Physical activity may be non-exercise, as carrying out one daily activity, or exercise-based, which are purposefully planned and structured. All exercises are physical activities, but not all physical activities are exercise. Exercise, therefore, is a subset of physical activity that is performed based on specific objectives. Sport could be classified as either exercise physical activity or exercise for optimizing performance. What delineates movement from exercise and physical activity is the motive attached to such movement. Movement in its natural state is a reflex action, most of which are performed as either locomotive or non-locomotive actions, such as yawning, stretching from a sitting position, clapping or dancing. These are non-exercise reflex movements that may be beneficial to health and overall wellness. It may be informal, formal, and purposive for all situations. The effects and benefits of movement are not limited to caloric expenditure and physical fitness only, but also facilitate operations in almost every human system. Good or healthy body movement is associated with a person's ability to work effectively, enjoy leisure, be healthy, resist hypokinetic diseases, and meet emergencies without undue fatigue holistically. From the submission of Bowen, with the encompassing definition of movement, mere prescription of exercise may not be adequate unless there is the understanding that movement relates to other non-fitness outcomes in the body. For example, those without access to exercise experts and facilities will only benefit from encompassing movement. Another factor that makes movement study holistic is that it considers nutritional mismatch, where and balance of the individual's energy. Play is mostly unplanned, with no rigid rules attached, and mostly spontaneously aroused and participated in. As you can see in your tent, fire on the mountain, do as I do, play with your child on the mat. These are all forms of play. Household chores as informal movement. Chores simply means the regular or daily life work of a household or farm, a routine task or chore done regularly at home, which help give life responsibility and self-reliance. And chores are an opportunity for adequate complex movement for optimal health. Household chores include sweeping, vacuuming, washing dishes, feeding pets and other animals, preparing your meals, pounding yam with mortar, grinding pepper with a grinding stone, and so on. According to Cleaner, doing chores around the house does not only burn calories and build muscles, but are also a very good medium for cardiovascular and strength training exercise under good ambience. In May Journal 2021, 10 household chores with specific benefits on men's health and fitness were highlighted. Painting as examples of some rotational movement, overhead press, squatting and stretching. While calf washing stretches the stabilizing muscles of the shoulders and promotes rotational movements that open up the shoulder, we tend to hunch over and run from several hours of computer and smartphone use. Others include raking your leaves, tree pruning and cutting, mulching, treating, cleaning the garden, fence remover, among others. For those who feel busy, occupational schedules prevent them from exercising. Doing household work is an opportunity to effectively participate in physical activity with the same reward as going to the gym. Despite household chores may not be the 150 to 300 minutes per week, physical activity required for health and fitness. It is, however, better than not doing any physical activity. Occupational physical movement. Occupational physical movement encompasses all physical activity in one job or career, such as standing for long hours as a field executive, soldier, policeman, or traffic warden. Others involve performing light to moderate lifting or doing manual labor on a construction site. Few studies have examined the contribution of occupational physical activity levels in Nigeria. Technological and urban transitions over time have changed the movement lifestyle of many occupations. A 2011 systematic review of 10 studies found that individuals with higher status occupations, that is, white collar or non-manual labor, have lower total physical activity compared to individuals with lower status job, blue collar job, or manual labor. Manual workers were found to be more likely to meet total physical activity guidelines measured as 10,000 steps by day, but these associations vary by gender. Depending on the cultural setting, occupational movement promotes selective physical fitness, informing the need for whole body movement for total wellness and health. My contribution to knowledge of occupational physical activity. Our study on the influence of occupational physical activity on anthropometric profile and body composition of bricklayers in Kwara State, Nigeria, delineated bricklaying as a high-intensity, moderately high-intensity occupational physical activity. An occupational movement increased body fat accumulation and obesity risk and all related disease decrease. Thus, an occupational movement has health and fitness benefits on body composition, upper body adaptation, strength and resistance to fatigue, which are required for optimal occupational performance. Involvement in exercise will therefore consolidate and prevent selective ailment. Religion as informal movement. Religion rituals are sources of movement with diverse modes of worship. Prayer and worship postures have been observed to be beneficial to fitness and wellness. For example, Salat involves continuous gentle muscle contraction and relaxation with perfect harmony and balance. Different types of stretching and isometric contraction exercise involved in religious rituals, including standing, sitting, twisting, flexing the trunk and the legs as well. Public health awareness is crucial to gain maximum physical health benefits associated with prayer postures in almost all religions. The Christians clapping, praise work, prayer, and kneeling are beneficial for aerobic fitness, flexibility thereby, alleviating pains and reducing physical inactivity. There is a need for people of different faiths to consciously participate in religious physical activity for multidimensional benefits. Formal movement. Formal movement are professionally designed programs to achieve health or performance enhancement, such as in physical education, practical physical education and sport are misconstrued as synonymous terms. Physical education is an academic discipline which deals with the development of an individual physically, mentally, socially, spiritually, psychologically, among others, through physical activities. The goal of physical education in school curriculum is to prepare students to live physically active, healthy lifestyle through carefully planned school and sequence of learning experiences. Sports are used to illustrate physical education in schools and add to functionalize learning and its experiences by which sports practice is promoted. This implies that through physical education classes, students build skills for plays and games, which may eventually lead to sports pursuit in life or friendly competitiveness for optimal career performance. Physical literacy and movement for life. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, literacy is the motivation, confidence, physical competence, knowledge and understanding of an individual to value and take responsibility for engagement in physical activity for life. Everyone has the potential to value, develop and maintain positive physical activity behavior for lifelong well-being. However, many people consider it a waste of time. Due to its numerous opportunities in multiple environments, benefits to health development of the whole person, physical literacy was recognized as one of the major goals of physical education in 2014 by the Society of Health and Physical Educators. It is expected that the physically literate individual demonstrate competency in a variety of motor skills and movement patterns that can apply the knowledge of concepts, principles, strategies, and tactics related to movement and performance. Therefore, the physically illiterate is not motivated and lack confidence, knowledge and understanding to value and take responsibility for maintaining purposeful physical pursuit that span a lifetime. Which one do you belong to? Study of human movement and movement science. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, if the different human kinesiology is a broad area of study, figure 9 depicts the disciplines in movement science. Movement science, which has been named variously by different disciplines, environment or institution, has become universally important because it concerns every human regardless of any differences. Movement science, according to the University of Idaho, is a professional discipline where one can study movement, physical activities, exercise, performing arts, leisure or recreation, sports, health and injury care, and prevention to promote a healthy and productive professional practice and lifestyle. The University of Idaho, with a Department of Movement Sciences under the College of Education in the Faculty of Health and Human Sciences, aspires to cultivate health and physically active lifestyles to sustain the well-being of individuals and communities as its vision. In Kenyatta University in East Africa, the entire curriculum restructuring led to creating the School of Education, in which a School of Public Health and Applied Human Science houses the following: Departments of Physical Education and Exercise and Sports Science, Community Health and Epidemiology, Environmental and Occupational Health, Health Management and Informatics, and Population, Reproductive Health and Community Resources. This was done to meet their nation's needs and to avoid unhealthy competition. Movement studies therefore create perspectives for long-term interdisciplinary studies, thus providing opportunities to all specialists in all scientific disciplines. The current trend in Nigeria demands a need to develop new courses of studies that meet the societal needs rather than general courses that limit career prospects. Exercise and sports science, a multidisciplinary specialization. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, exercise and sports science is a multidimensional discipline that integrates all aspects of human movement to develop improved health, sport performance, and total body functions. Exercise and sports science offers multidisciplinary solutions to performance problems in different practical settings through a balanced view of issues influencing participation in physical exercise and sport. A multidisciplinary solution is the capacity to integrate knowledge and modes of thinking therefore, is concerned with the way the body responds to exercise and training, limitation due to environmental influences such as altitude, heat, cold, temperate, among others, and how athletes and exercisers can acclimatize in such a demanding environment to optimize performance, either for health or sports competition. Sport and exercise psychological dimension is a subdiscipline of sport and exercise science which answers questions about human behavior in sport and exercise setting. Psychological factors may contribute to whether an individual achieves success, optimal performance in sport, or may also affect whether an individual chooses to engage with exercise. The psychological dimension of human movement studies is designed to provide scientific understanding of human behavior, experience, and the complex interactions between them in competitive and recreational sports and exercise. Motor control and development studies, the acquisition of cross and fine movement skills, and how they are transformed into fundamental and specialized skills for activity of daily living, movement behavior, and specialized skills in recreation and sport and dance. Motor control and motor learning are central to the discipline of exercise and sport science, in which motor control is concerned with the physiological process whereby motor development occurs, while motor learning allows motor development to occur systematically, resulting in a permanent change in motor behavior due to experience. Good movement health and childhood bends towards healthy physical culture in adulthood, naturally developing good metrics in locomotive, non-locomotive, and fundamental movement, which are transferred to specialized skills needed in physical activities and sportive movement. Sociological dimension of human movement. Sociological dimension of human movement utilizes sociological methods and inquiries to inform individual practice towards physical literacy, physical activity, exercise, and sport. Such individual or group practice challenge the conduct of their own beliefs in sports and exercise in the society. Sports and physical activity are deeply embedded in the society, leading to the need to examine many social and cultural factors that influence human physical performance, physical activity, behavior of groups of people or society. Studies have shown that human movement noticeably is routine activities of daily living. Physical activity and exercise, sports and PE, are motivated either as participants by talking to friends and family about physical activity and sports, or by watching as spectators. Social processes in sports strengthen public opinion as a prestigious sphere of employment and promote cultural linkage. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, my interest and contribution in the sociological dimension of movement in early sports led to an investigation of the communication techniques coaches adopted to relate with athletes in training and before, during, and after matches. The findings revealed that no matter the level of skill and fitness, communication of coaches and with athletes, within athletes, and between athletes and coaches contribute to correct human movement, learning techniques, and performance at all levels. Furthermore, the level of coaches' communication techniques tends to determine losing or winning, as well as involvement in sport for all. Biomechanical dimension of sports and exercise. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, the biomechanical dimension of my dream area is my dream area of focus, but has become a mirage due to lack of necessary tools. All human movements are produced and modified by internal or external forces. The extent of movement is explained by the interplay of forces and techniques and the musculoskeletal system, the basics of mechanical principles of human movement. Biomechanics of human movement, with an emphasis on sports and exercise, is a discipline that studies the techniques of human movement using the tools of mechanics and interrelationship of anatomy and physiology and mathematics to improve performance. Biomechanical analysis in sports, exercise, and musculoskeletal health. Biomechanical analysis is the systematic study of human movement that involves careful observation and the use of instruments to measure body movement, body mechanics, and muscle activity. Simply put, it is analysis of movement techniques. Biomechanical analysis can be performed using one or all of the quantitative, qualitative, or predictive methods to gather information about the mechanics of the musculoskeletal system when executing a motor task, or to determine how best movement may be produced to enhance the structures and function of the body, understand injuries, and promotion. The assessment of these variables can also be used for ascertaining training and exercise needs, response to exercise programs, as well as predicting the health status of an individual. Musculoskeletal biomechanics and health. One of the recent sources of traumatic health equivalent of 568 million people and the leading cause of disability in 160 countries. The problem of musculoskeletal pain is complex and wide-ranging and includes different types of pain, such as neck pain, limb pain, lower back pain, bone pain, associated with pain in the joints, and chronic generalized pain, among others. One of the factors responsible for the increase in musculoskeletal pain in Nigeria is technological advancement that leads to a low level of movement. In one of our studies, we found that the use of ICT devices, such as computers, mobile phones, and tablets, was a common cause of musculoskeletal pain in the University of Ilorin community. Performance and movement studies. Concept of performance. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir. The term performance was recognized in the mid-19th century and was first used in defining the results of a sporting contest from Manson's motto, "Don't lower your expectations to meet your performance. Raise your level of performance to meet your expectations." This led to the development of theories from various fields, with particular attention to the works of Turner and Skinner, who illustrated the performative nature of societies around the world, how events and rituals, as well as daily life, were all governed by a code of performance. Performance theory suggests that every one of us puts on a performance in our society, whether through the clothes we wear, the conversation we hold, or the food we eat. All are a performance designed as a signal system to ourselves and others for our place within our social group. Performance and movement interaction. Performance is a multidimensional abstract concept whose measurement depends on several factors, including the movement enterprise, the physical activity and exercise program, departments of movement professionals involved, manager, and the performer, with the measurement objective of assessing the effect of performance and performing behavior. In Movement for Life, the measurement of performance effect may be based on the following expected outcomes: 1, developing health-related fitness; 2, elite sports; and 3, rehabilitation. Performance is also relevant in determining the efficiency of curriculum design and implementation of professional training programs, exercise prescription, and administration based on normal special population. Furthermore, these outcomes help in assessing the effectiveness of set objectives for performance. This is long overdue to meet the needs of the contemporary society. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, I want to call your attention that what is going on with the minimum benchmark for our physical education, human kinetics, sports science curriculum in Nigeria are just 1, change of name 2, modifications rather than restructuring to meet societal needs and best practices. Change is inevitable if the course of study must meet the needs of our community and help our graduates find their feet to stand tall independently. Poor performance has been attributed to either individual level of physical literacy and physical culture of the community where he or she belongs, attitude to change, disposition to set objectives, acceptability, and level of participation. Inadequate movement education promotion, acceptability, and implementation have caused the society and all the social systems loss of manpower, huge medical bills due to cardiovascular disease, metabolic disorders, rising morbidity and mortality rates. Sport and exercise science is imagined and focuses on collaborative efforts to optimize human performance through movement behavior patterns and interaction with the environment, as in the home, school, workplace, and or interaction with implements and interrelationship within social groups, sports, and other physical activity settings. The Sustainable Development Goal 3 of Good Health and Wellbeing's mission statement to ensure healthy lives and promote well-being for all at all ages is a proof, in fact, on the need to develop a focused curriculum-based movement education programs at all educational levels to optimize societal movement health and performance to reduce the high cost of non-communicable disease and mortality rates. Movement and pain, the physical activity interlude. Pain is defined as an unpleasant sensory and emotional experience associated with actual or potential tissue damage described in terms of damage. Clinically, pain is often the primary motivator for people to seek medical care, while simultaneously serving as common barrier for adherence to the prescribed movement. Studies have described that pain and movement are universally relevant phenomena that influence human experiences in readily observable ways. An in-depth understanding of pain and movement relationships is beneficial not only in medical and rehabilitation guidance, but also in prevention and promotion of healthy neuromuscular systems of the human body, taking advantage of physical activity lifestyle. proven that a sedentary lifestyle contributes to diverse pains of the musculoskeletal disorder and is associated with impaired movement. Other studies also supported that promoting healthy lifestyle in the whole population may have beneficial effects on the prevention of pain, complaints, and its consequences. Use of endorphin release therapy was also effective in alleviating pain among indoor athletes in senior high school central region of Ghana. Hence, this therapy is recommended for the quick recovery and return of injured athletes to performance and ultimately health and well-being. Wellness continuum and movement interaction. Wellness is more about living life fully as a lifestyle and personalized approach of living that allows a person to attain the best that his or her potential, circumstances, and fate permits. To achieve this, individuals need good stewardship for themselves, those under their care, those who care for them, as well as others, a fading culture in our communal lifestyle. The movement wellness continuum. As you can see, the movement wellness continuum represents a spectrum well-being state lying between two critical zones, red and blue. The number 0 to 10 depicts the body's level of organization from health states or disorganization from disease states. When 10 is optimal health, our utmost goal, 7 to 9 is good health, 4 to 6 is comfort zone, a place of forced wellness. We are due to lack of symptoms, one could deceitfully slide into poor health, disease, or mortality. And 0 to 4, we should be avoided completely. The dimensions of wellness are mutually interdependent and must be given attention. They are intellectual wellness, emotional wellness, social wellness, spiritual wellness, occupational wellness, financial wellness, environmental wellness, and physical wellness, which is about taking care of the body to stay healthy now and in the future. Physical wellness is linked to physical health or your internal safety and involves understanding that good diets, exercise, and healthy lifestyle choices are important. Physical wellness recognizes that our daily habits and behaviors have an impact on our overall health, well-being, and quality of life. Hence the emphasis on physical literacy. Movement implication for wellness is that wellness is a holistic commitment to positive health behaviors, movement, and mortality risk. A lot has been espoused on movement, its components, forms, and metrics. In the exercise and sports science field, the discussion of human movement is incomplete without mentioning physical inactivity or sedentariness. The reason is that regardless of age, gender, physical fitness, and health status, inactivity and sedentariness are unhealthy human movement behaviors that increase the risk of mortality. Physical inactivity is defined as not engaging in any form of physical activity of moderate or vigorous intensity, or engaging in physical activity that does not meet WHO's recommendation to participate in physical activity per week. Sedentariness, on the other hand, has been operationalized to include activities of very minimal movement and total time spent during waking hours or reclining or excessive sitting. A mention of the word mortality often rightly This may have resulted in frequent mortality among the civil servants during active service or shortly after their retirement. Interventions for people with these symptoms may include medical care or movement regimen or both, depending on severity. Sedentariness, an independent risk factor of mortality. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, sedentariness is regarded as an independent risk factor for cardiovascular and metabolic diseases that increase the risk for mortality. For example, overweight, obesity, and other diseases. Engaging in exercise or other forms of physical activity is the most potent way to decrease inactivity and sedentariness, and these are known to induce dose response health and fitness benefits on the body. An underlying risk to most individuals, including active people, is that sedentariness is often a common habit that is entrenched by various social environment needs. For example, our occupation, use of vehicles, studying, our social life, relaxation, among others. Our awareness actions against this sedentariness are therefore necessary to avoid mortality. Several studies confirming the risk of mortality from sedentariness support this necessity. For example, our study found that despite most of our subjects meeting physical activity recommendations, ICT-induced sedentariness led to excessive body fat accumulation, which is an indicator of sedentary death syndrome among sanguine students of the University of Ilorin. Brown et al. Reported that the odds of substantive weight gain of greater than 5 kilograms over 5 years was significantly higher among those whose average daily sitting time was greater than or equal to 8 hours per day, compared to those who sat less than 3 hours per day. In addition, Shield and Tremblay reported that obesity rose from 14% to 25% among men whose average daily TV time was less than or equal to 5 hours per week to greater than or equal to 21 hours per week, and from 11% to 24% among women independent of leisure time physical activity and diet. Sedentariness in children increases mortality rates. The risk of hypertension in obese children was increased 3 to 0.3 times among those who spent greater than or equal to 4 hours viewing TV, compared to those who spend less than 2 hours per day viewing TV. Based on this evidence, a positive movement behavior, which includes complying with physical activity and sedentary behavior recommendation, is required to confer health, fitness, wellness benefits, and minimize mortality rates, or at least improve one's quality of life. An intervention study that we conducted on a neglected stroke survivor's post-traumatic experience revealed that an 8-week 20-meter walk improved cardiorespiratory fitness and strength of shoulder extensor, hip extensor, and dorsiflexor of stroke survivors outpatient in 2 tertiary hospitals in Oshogbo, Nigeria. The need for implementing formal movements as routine life.
Physical activity is integral in the prevention and treatment of diseases and should be regularly assessed.
shifting the responsibility of controlling body weight impedes health progress from the individual to the